In this video, I'm going to show you how to get up and running with GrooveView in 3 simple steps. Stick around to the end of the video for a bonus tip. Now, this is going to be just a very high level overview, just enough to get your feet wet and give you the confidence you need to get started. For more detailed instructions, be sure to check out all of our other GrooveView videos on opto22.com, training.opto22, and on our YouTube channel. For this video, you're going to need either a Groove Epic, a legacy Groove Box, or Groove Server for Windows, and your favorite web browser running on the same network. I'll be using this Groove Epic Training Center, which is just a standard Groove Epic with some pre-wired buttons, lights, and sensors used for training. You can learn more about Groove Epic Training on opto22.com. Now, with that introduction out of the way, let's get started. So, assuming you already have your Groove Epic processor or Groove Server for Windows up and running, we can now move on to creating your first GrooveView HMI. GrooveView comes in 2 basic components. There's View Mode, where you view and interact with your HMIs, and Build Mode, where you build your HMIs. Now, while GrooveView works awesome on the Groove Epic touchscreen or any other mobile device, we highly recommend using a desktop or laptop computer for building your HMIs. It's just a lot easier. I'll be using this Mac with Chrome, but of course you can use whatever modern browser or computer you want. Let's get started. I'm already logged into my Groove Epic, and I've got the Groove Manage homepage open. To open GrooveView, click on, you guessed it, GrooveView. GrooveView opens first in View Mode. Since I haven't made any pages yet, there's nothing to see here. Click on the menu gear icon on the top right-hand side and select Switch to Build Mode. So here we are in Build Mode. To the left is where you add pages and categories. Let's first create a category. I'll call it Category 1. Now let's make a page to live under that category. I'll call it Page 1. So far, so good. Below the pages and categories is where you find the page properties. You can change the name of the page here. Below that, you can change the background color. But let's just stick with white for now. Below that, you can edit page permissions. Here you can select access rights. I don't have any users set up yet, and I'm not going to get into setting up permissions just now. That is covered in more detail in the Users and Permissions episode of this series. So I'll just leave access rights to all users. Below that is the option to show or hide the page in the menu on the GrooveView side of things. I'll leave that unchecked. Here is the main desktop and tablet work area. This is where you arrange the gadgets for your HMI. In the lower right is where you find gadgets to drag into the desktop window. You can also use the Tags tab. Find the tag you are looking for, and then only the appropriate gadgets for that tag type will be displayed. I don't have any tags added yet. That is covered in more detail than other videos. So to keep things moving along, I'm going to go back to the Gadgets tab, scroll down, and grab a button gadget. Notice that as soon as I dropped that button gadget onto the workspace, a new window appeared in the top right. This is the Gadget Properties panel. As the name suggests, this is where you configure your gadget's properties. I'll start by creating a tag. Like I said, adding tags is covered in other videos, so I'm going to skip over that process. But you don't need to create any tags to make your first HMI. Just use the handy built-in data simulator tags. I'll stick to the basics. Notice how if I scroll down here, it grays out any tags that are not appropriate for the selected gadget. A button is either on or off, so these don't apply. I'll select this bool A and hit Update Gadget. I'm going to make it a bit bigger so I can see what's going on. Below the tag, you have the option to confirm rights. This will create a little pop-up window in View Mode asking to confirm your selection. This is to prevent accidental clicks. Just leave it unchecked for now. Below that is the display mode. We have the choice of a button or image. I'll get into image options later in the bonus round. For now, leave button selected. Below that, we can give the button a name. I'll call it Bool A. I'll choose a smaller text size and leave the font as Arial. Scroll down, change the on indicator to green and the off to red. I'll leave the text color and button color as is. Next, I'll drag in an LED gadget. I will also assign it to that same bool variable. I'll label it bool A. Change the text size to 16 and leave all the other formatting as is. By default, the LED graphic size is set to auto. If I increase or decrease the size of the gadget bounding box, the LED gets bigger and smaller. I'm going to set this one to 3. Stretch it out a bit. I'll change the true color to green and the false to red. Let's check it out. Go to File, Save All Changes, and switch to Groove View. Here we go. If I click on the Bool A button, its indicator changes from red to green, and the LED changes from red to green also. All right, let's go back to the gear menu icon and select Switch to Build Mode. Check it out. Up here, next to the Desktop and Tablet tab, is the Handheld tab. This is where you create your responsive page for smaller vertical screens, like a phone or the Epic touchscreen. Notice that the gadgets that I made in the Desktop tab have already been added and configured in the Handheld tab. I'm going to just straighten them out a bit here. When I switch back to the Desktop tab, everything that I arranged earlier stayed the same. That's great. Let's go up to File and hit Save All Changes. Let's check it out on the Groove Epic touchscreen. And on my phone. Awesome, couldn't be easier. Now, for a little bonus round, let's switch back to build mode and I'll show you something really cool. I'm gonna move this button and LED off to the side for now. Do you see this area here with the dotted line? This is called the stash. It's on the Desktop tab too. If you don't see the stash, you can go down here and click on Zoom Out to show page stash. The stash is a really handy place to store gadgets that you have configured but don't want to use right now. You can just stash them over here on the side. It's really handy to have this extra space when designing your HMI. It's also great if you want to have some gadgets on your desktop and tablet view, but not on your handheld view, or vice versa. Let's take things up a notch and add some pretty pictures. I'm going to drag in an image gadget like so. Now I just need to add an image. But wait, you say, I'm not an artist, I don't have any pictures. Well, check this out. Open a new tab, go to opto22.com, select Support, scroll down to Resources and Tools, search for SVG Library, right here at the top. This is a secret treasure trove of free images that you can customize and use in your HMI. Look, there are hundreds of things you can use, from tanks of all shapes and sizes and various pieces of equipment, agriculture, indicators, HVAC, transportation, tons of stuff. I'm going to grab a simple tank, change its color to blue, hit Prepare for Download. That opens a little pop-up. Down here is the Download Image button, and that just saved to my desktop. Now I want to add a valve to my tank. I'll find that up here in the Flow Images. Here we go. I'll take a valve open, make it blue, download. I'll also get a valve closed, make it blue, download. All set. Let's go back to the Groove Build tab. Under the Properties panel, just click on the image, and that opens the image library. As the name implies, the image library is where you store all of your images. Let's add that tank and open and close valves. Click on Add New Images. Select those guys. There they are. For this image gadget, I want to use the tank, so I'll click on it. There we go. I'm not going to assign this tank any tags. It's just a picture of a tank. It doesn't do anything. But remember that button gadget and how it had the button or image option? Let's try that out. I'm going to grab that button that we have saved over in the stash and drag it in. I'll change the display mode from button to image. Choose my on image as the valve open and the off image as the valve closed. I'll resize and reposition a little. And I'll bring in that LED too. I don't need the text, so I'm just going to delete that in the Properties panel. And I'm going to change the size back to auto. Now I want to put it on top of my tank, but notice when I drag it in, it disappears behind it. That is because all the gadgets that you drag into the workspace have a Z space order. You can change that order by right-clicking on the gadget and select Bring to Front. There we go. Now I'll resize a little. Don't forget to clean up the handheld view. I'll tidy things up a bit. Let's go to File, hit Save All Changes, and switch to Groove View. Looks good. When I click on the valve, it opens and closes, and the LED light changes from red to green. Awesome. Same thing on the Groove Epic touchscreen. And on my phone. That's it. You're now a Groove View HMI Building Master. Play around with all the other gadgets. Everything in here is really intuitive and easy to use. Use the data simulator to create some fun simulated automation scenarios. Bookmark the SVG library page and browse through the mountains of free images. And when you're ready, be sure to check out the other videos in this series on opto22.com and on our YouTube channel. And don't forget to check out the 100% free Opto University, our incredible free training resource for all things Opto22, Node-RED, Ignition, Pack Control, MQTT, and more. If you have any questions or need any help, remember, support is always free and with a real Opto22 engineer. Lastly, join the community on Opto forums and get support from Opto22 power users. Have fun, guys.